Bombshell, major congressional scandal breaks, this is nasty. Victims of sexual harassment are coming out of the woodwork as they come forward with allegations against prominent members of society. According to Fox News, radio show host Laura Ingraham reveals a disturbing discovery within Congress. There's an entire fund for Congress members to pay off victims and accusers, and it's cost taxpayers $15.2 million over the past few years. This disturbing revelation is even more shocking considering many high-ranking officials within Congress, like House Oversight Committee member Jim Jordan, R.O., don't even know it exists, according to Ms. Ingraham. Adding on to the already shocking news that taxpayers are funding this disgusting behavior is that certain members of Congress are aware of their colleagues' foul activities and are choosing to hide it, even when they come forward. According to Politico, Representatives Jackie Speier, DCA, and Barbara Comstock, RVA, both testified to the House Administration Committee of members of Congress engaging in sexual harassment. Rep. Speier said she knew of two lawmakers, Republican and Democrat, who have engaged in such behavior. Rep. Comstock told of one individual who decided to expose himself to a young female staffer when she made a delivery to his home. According to Rep. Comstock, the young woman was greeted with a member in a towel who, after inviting her in to drop off the materials, exposed himself to her. Both women called for stronger anti-harassment policies, but neither revealed the identities of the individuals they knew were engaging in the perverted behavior. They kept their identities secret. It's stunning that these female lawmakers, who knew the identities of sexual deviants in Congress, would call for a light to be shed on these issues and greater punishments for the perpetrators, yet not reveal those they knew engaging in such behavior. Ms. Ingraham asks, why aren't they naming names? Why aren't others naming names? She stated that all lawmakers have the obligation to reveal such acts and behaviors committed by their colleagues and to also reveal who benefited from the so-called shush fund. Ms. Ingraham points out that members of Congress are employees of the American people and are beholden to them. We all have a right to know. They work for us. I want the names of the members accused. Representative Greg Harper, RMS, firmly stated that such conduct should not be tolerated and that fellow members of Congress should hold themselves and others to an even higher standard than before. There is no place for sexual harassment in our society, period, and especially in Congress. Ms. Ingraham stated that the U.S. is home to a government of the people, by the people and for the people, not the government of anonymous groupers. It's unclear what's more upsetting, that Congress members are sexually harassing others, that their colleagues are keeping it a secret, or that taxpayers are footing the bill for such behaviors. These individuals in Congress, or any walk of life for that matter, need to be punished for their sexually deviant activities and behaviors. In Congress' case, a great first step would be to reveal the identities of known perpetrators and issue a policy that would force these perverted individuals to pay for their own crimes.